talk about the different types of supply chain risks. I would say the first point is the entire strategy that we are using to reach our customer. Whether that strategy is properly baked and aligned to our objectives. If we do not strategize properly on who should be my supplier, where should be my manufacturing facility, how am I going to reach my consumer, then the entire supply chain is at risk right from the very beginning. The second would be market related risks. So I may have a very good product today, but there may be a disruptor that comes in tomorrow. That introduces a completely external risk. So I have to be cognizant of what's happening around me in order to understand that type of a risk. The third would be the implementation of my strategy. I made a very good strategy, but am I also good at implementing it and continuously reviewing and changing it? As we just discussed that the markets itself are so dynamic, so am I good at implementing those mitigations of my risk due to my strategy? My performance also is a kind of a risk, because if I don't perform well in my SLAs or being able to serve my customer, why would the customer come to me? So my entire supply chain performance is also a risk. Let's go to demand. So I may have a constant demand for the last 2 years, but suddenly there is a natural disaster in a particular place, which reduces that particular demand to zero for the next 1 or 2 months. Am I prepared for that? Because that is again a very viable risk. Now my supply chain requires some investment at any point of time. So one is my operational costs and the other are my capital costs. Operational costs help me tide over the capital tide in the inventory. So financially, am I stable enough to take care of those capital requirements? So I have to be very thorough in my numbers, otherwise I introduce a financial risk in my supply chain. The next would be scope of schedule. So I should know very clearly what I am required to deliver at what point of time. And that should be communicated well enough to all the stakeholders, right from the customer to the supplier. So the entire scope of schedule, if not properly communicated, developed, also introduces assumptions in different minds, which leads to risk. Now there are many legal aspects related to the product, related to my operations, related to my financials. So I have to make sure that I am covered legally in all aspects, and these are again very dynamic in nature. So tomorrow a law may come into place which puts operations in a particular state at risk because they have introduced a new tax law. So we have to be covered in terms of all legal aspects when I'm considering all my supply chain risks. Nowadays we have to consider the environmental factors, both in terms of, is my product green enough, is my supply chain green enough, and also am I contributing to harming the environment or am I contributing to making it much better. So as we know that most consumers, governments, everybody is leaning towards a more greener environment. So I have to make sure that my entire process, supply chain, product is more towards greener side rather than disrupting it. There are socio-political elements of the risk, social behavior affects how the product is received or how people work in that particular area. If there's an upwardly mobile society, so today my entire supply chain talent cost may be low, but as that society moves upward, my costs of talent may go up. So I have to be cognizant of some socio-political risks that are also there in operating my particular supply chain. The project organization of me being able to deliver a certain scope of work in a certain period of time. So I have to make sure that my entire organization, right from the top to the foot workers, are such that they'll be able to deliver that particular scope of work in that period of time. Now, in order to do this, I also have to be cognizant of human behavior, which works across cultures, across societies, and may be different. So I have to ensure that I understand all the different behavioral aspects of different human beings, because if one doesn't work well with the other, then I have a scope of disruption. This also covers these cultural aspects, because most of the companies are now working across cultures. So I have to make sure that when they work together, there is no cultural clash. And finally, there is a manufacturing risk in the entire supply chain, that I have to ensure that my manufacturing capacity is sustainable day over a period of time. If that gets disrupted, then there is no product to transfer or to sell. Thank you.